continuing our celebration and putting a spotlight on our LGBTQ+ babes in the music industry, we are going to check out Years and Years today. Now, I'm going to be honest, not familiar in the slightest, but you guys have been telling me that it's a really good band. 16 songs, about an hour. I don't recognize any of it at all, so this is going to be a wild ride. So strap in and let's go. I love how the first song I can't even pronounce. Are we surprised? I have the reading ability of a third grader at this point. I'm so. Also, I wanted to look at these lyrics real quick. Give me your confession, saying lately life's been tearing you apart. Some breaks, identify my body with pains. I love you, crave. Okay. So he's basically saying like, hey man, you going through some shit? Guess what? I've been through some shit. Let's go through it together. Sanctify. What the? My sins when I pray, boy. What are your sins? What are you sinful for?
Let me know.
What does that remind me of? What was that one artist? Cascada? You know what? I hope through this album, not only do I find a new soul, a new mentality, I hope I find a new body, because I am 22 years old, but I have the bones of an 80-year-old, and I am sick and tired of it. Ooh. You know what, y'all? For once, I'm wearing pants. Do you know what that means? You guys, you know I do not go to clubs. I do not really go to bars. It's not my scene. I'm a lightweight and it's embarrassing. But my ass would go for this. Let me take a shot. Let me get on the dance floor. I'm gonna be the Stevie Wonder of Michael Jackson's. It's gonna be a mess, but you know what? I'm gonna have a good ass time. We love her. We stan her. God damn. I mean, like, the lyrics from what I could pick up, you know, they're playful, they're fun, there's still like a bit of a deeper meaning to it. I see a hair in my eye. I think I got it. But it's still really fun. I feel like if you were to go to a Years and Years show, you're gonna get your emo bops. Granted, this is the second song, so I could totally be talking out of my ass right now. But you're gonna get your emo bops and you're gonna have your fun ones. All for you. Oh, I'm already in love with this production. Ooh, everyone sees a man so tall, so perfect, they say. I've been thinking, was it all a different scene in my head? You've got powers, you instructed all the demons instead. Everyone sees a man so tall. So perfect, they said. Yeah, you've got ambition. I thought we'd grow in time. I wasn't prepared. And now am I forgiven? Oh, you look like you're so damn scared. I don't really think you care. You know that our time is through. It's over when I leave, you said. We're never gonna meet again. You played your game. It was all for you. This could go two ways. This could be about a relationship, a toxic one at that, or it could be about himself. Listen, it is the third song on the album. This feeling, this moment where, like, I'm speechless doesn't usually come until halfway through the album or almost the end. The fact that I'm sitting here and I'm like, wait a minute, why am I gonna fall in love with this man? Why do I want to spend all my money on a concert ticket right now? This is not good. It's so fun, but the lyrics are there and his voice. Oh, honey, is his voice so good? I don't know. Why does it seem like this is a really well-rounded band? And why am I just now, like, stepping on the train? I mean, we've been known. I'm always late. I'm always late to the party. But goddamn, this isn't okay. Karma is a bitch. So am I. Girl, once you know how to do that, find the beauty in your flaws, please let a bitch know, because we're struggling over here. But goddamn, is it hard to get to that point where it's like, yep, this is me, I accept it, and I'm okay with it. I don't know. Does anyone ever get to that point? Like, is anyone ever truly happy? I don't think true happiness is a real thing. That's for a different video, though. Ooh. I like the idea of personifying karma and being like, listen, she's this bitch and she's coming after me, but it's good karma. For all y'all that were like, I'm never gonna make it, I'm never gonna succeed, I can never be happy, you better watch your back. Please tell me I'm getting my emo bob. Ugh. I had a dream, a ship that we sailed in the night. Flowers bloom with no regret. Just one more look at you. My heart has been hypnotized. Oh, you're joking. I totally did ask. What am I even saying? Oh, like, that's everything that I could ever want in an emo bop. I don't know what it was, though, that got me on the verge of tears halfway through the song. The lyrics were just very honest and very relatable. Because it's not like I can sit here and be like, oh, it made me think of blah, 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 because it didn't. A lot of the hetero men, as we've discussed on this channel, have disappointed me quite a bit. So, yeah, that didn't happen. Maybe that's why I got sad, because I need a hetero. Do I though? I don't know. Oh god, he's gonna make me pop my ass after almost having a mental breakdown. Hello? Your pretty eyes. Why did I think he was gonna say Prius? The way he was saying it was like Prius. Why the fuck would he be talking about someone's Prius? My mind. It amazes me sometimes where it can go. Why do I love that? Ooh, it's a be a man. Okay, sorry. Okay. Did I detect an accent? If you're over me, that means you're not under me. So sorry. I love that. That's sampled, isn't it? There I said it. Don't look at me all offended. Whoever this man is, he is a bad bitch and needs to be recognized, because that whole verse right there, yesterday you said I'm the one, but now you say that you're done. Stop telling me what I need, baby, if you're over me. And then it goes into, there you go, there I said it. He's like, You can't seem to say it, so I'm gonna say it for you, and we're gonna figure this shit out. Don't look at me all offended. You played games and it ended. I've got to look out for me. I won't say that it's easy. Oh, I know I hate leaving, but you can't keep deceiving. Does it make you feel good? Because, bitch, it doesn't make us feel good. No. No. Wow, I like that bridge. Why did I really enjoy that one? Like, there was something about it that was just really fun-go-lucky. Like, I almost feel like it could play... Like, the instrumental could play for a Target commercial. Maybe a little bit? I don't know. Woo! What your father would say if he saw us. Well, you should admit it. You don't know who you are, but you're hoping that I'm gonna get to love you. And I'm trying, yeah, I'm trying, but you knock me down. You do. Oh, because I really want to love you. But you're hiding. Yeah, you're hiding. You should come on out. Come on out. I've said it before. I'll say it again. I'm a broken record, but... Like, that's just... Ugh. It's just so annoying that it has to still be, like, a thing. Like, why can't it just be, oh, he likes boys, oh, he likes girls, she likes girls. Like, I don't, it's 2019. Can everybody grow up? People are gay, Susan. It's fine. I would not give a damn what my child's sexuality is. Like, as long as they're happy and they're a good person, you know what I mean? Like, let's talk about things that they could be doing that is worse. They could be littering. They could be rude to people. They could be putting milk in the bowl before the cereal. Like, we have so many things that we could talk about before that. I wrote it down when I first met you. The way that you stared at me. Yeah. You never said the things you wanted. I think I touched the floor. I made a mistake. This went way different than what I was envisioning in my head. When it first started off and it was like, oh, I saw you and I wrote it down and blah, blah, blah. I was like, oh, okay, I can make you a little love story. And then it was like, nah, nah, homie. I dodged a bullet. Thank God. I was like, oh. Okay. I like this line though. You're so damn smart, you think you're special, but maybe I wouldn't agree. He's like, maybe you need to step off your high horse there. You're so deluded, you're such a fake, and now you got somebody else to manipulate. I think I dodged a bullet. I made a lucky escape. Damn, he's got... Bars. I'm sorry, I've been watching a lot of Cody Ko recently. Oh, hell yeah, let's go. Let's fucking go. I'm carving a sky. Having visions manifesting as I break. Burning, burning. And I'm giving in to your fever touch. Let it all. Do I look good in this position just like him? Speak in tongues, man. Speak with your tongue. Entertainment. Come on, come on, come on. Keep me craving this sweet intoxication. You're the darkness in me. Palo Santo. I don't even need to talk about that one. You already know. You already know. I'm not even gonna say anything. Shut the fuck up. What is this? It's an interlude. Take it from me. I don't want this one to end, no. Oh, I'm not you. I love that it was an interlude, but it's like, it's one of those interludes where it's a perfect interlude. Would not change a single damn thing. However, it's like, if it was a full song, like, I would have more time with it. She sing so good. Ooh. Oh girl, I thought that was going a different direction. I was like, how long until you play me? And I look like Boo Boo the Fool. I'm glad we're going the other way though. Oh. I used to be so ready to run. My philosophy song that would make me belong to you. This is a very like Jax Jones kind of track. I think it's a very smart collaboration. Just from listening to the album. My dude, is it that serious? Okay, this one I'm into, Meneg, right? Is that how you say his name? I know like his popular singles, and I know he released an album, and I've been meaning to just check it out, but I keep putting it off. We all know I'm the worst when it comes to this. But yeah, I really like his vibe, I like his voice, so I'm excited for this collab. Oh, hell yeah, guitar. So rich, such a great voice. Whoa, 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 whoa. Listen to it. Like, what? Bitch, take a breath. What? The fuck? What do you mean? No. Howl. Oh, I like this. It's sweet, like melodic kind of a production. Okay, listen, so if you're not new to this channel, you know, usually songs where it's like, this is me, I'm proud, kind of a thing, like, just makes me cringe. I don't know why. Like, they're so uplifting and they're so powerful, but yet to me, I'm like, please turn it off. This, however, like, wasn't cringy to me. Like, it was a good little anthem. Will it be my favorite? Let's not get crazy. I think honestly, for me personally, the production is what saved it. Sadness is secret, cause boys don't cry. Oh bitch, don't get me started on that. Don't panic, couldn't stand on the ground. Don't panic, nothing will pull me down. Don't panic, don't panic. Chest tight, lights too bright. Smile for the picture. I love that part though. Again, like, I think this album, production-wise, is one of the best pop albums that I've heard, I think, this year, honestly. If not the best, one of the best, because there have been a lot of strong albums that have come out already. We're only halfway through the year. We've had some good bops and some good times, but this is a really high contender for me production-wise on one of my favorites. That like made me kind of depressed. I think I hear songs like this and I think of how many of you guys I've actually talked to who have told me things that you fear with your family or with your sexuality or your identity or finding someone that you like and not knowing how to approach it and yada yada yada. And like, it's hard already in the world being a little hetero. It's hard, but I just couldn't even imagine having all that extra baggage, stress, whatever you may call it. Again, if we could just get to a place where it's not a big deal. I mean, everything's a big deal about yourself, who you are, how you identify. But if it could be something where it's just like, oh yeah, they're gay. Like, oh, the world would be such a better place. Anyway, going through the album, it's a very fun pop album. Again, I really like the production. I like the lyrics. There are some good bars in there. Let me tell you. Let me see. I don't know if this is this their first project? Oh no, they have another project out. Oh. Okay, we may have to check that out later. I don't know, I think it's really special to find artists that you can connect to or that you can even bop to, escape the world to. I mean, that's why I love music personally so much. It's helped me a lot in my struggles, especially as a teen, even as an adult. You know what I mean? Like, throughout life you go through different phases of struggles and growing and finding yourself, and I don't know, music seems to be that one consistent thing that gets me through it. And to find an artist like this that's just fun and can give me good vibes, I really appreciate that. And if it helps you guys with your identity and just not feeling alone, like, I'm down. Anyway, that's it for me. What are your favorite tracks from this album? Let me know in the comments down below. Don't forget to like, subscribe. Go check out my other channel for a different type of content for me besides reactions. I love you. Take care of yourselves, and I'll see you in the next one.